There's no denying that a big set of brakes behind your wheels looks cool, but is bigger always better? We're here with Phil from Alcon Brakes to discuss some of the more technical aspects of specifying a big brake kit for your vehicle. So when people are looking to upgrade their brakes for performance street cars or racing applications, is it a case of bigger is always better? Should they be looking at basically the biggest caliper and rotor package that they can fit under their wheels? Or is there more to it than that?
There's a little more to it than that. The size of the brakes is obviously very important, but there are more factors involved. The piston sizing in the caliper, the type of friction material, the actual weight of the parts is important as well, because you don't want something that's going to overbreak the car or run at the wrong type of temperature.
Right, so I guess if someone is struggling with front grip and locking up their brakes already, then adding bigger brakes really isn't going to help in most cases?
No, exactly. You need to have a balanced system that's, you know, properly engineered. So a front and rear setup that works well together, as well as friction material and everything else.
Right. So in terms of the weight we were talking about before, you've obviously got unsprung weight here, and also the rotor is rotating as well, which adds another factor into the mix. What do you kind of see as more important there about minimizing the rotating weight and the unsprung weight from the rotor or the caliper weight just being unsprung? Is that considered the two different types of unsprung weight?
Yeah, it really is. I mean, the important thing in terms of braking is the weight of the rotor, that's your heat sink. So you going too light on the rotor will cause problems with brake fade, overheating, and the rotor itself just not lasting. A caliper is a little bit different. You can save weight on a caliper, but the important thing is that in saving weight, you don't reduce the stiffness, because the stiffness of the caliper is what gives you the pedal feel and the efficiency in your system.
Yeah, right. Okay. So just having a look at the GT series brakes we've got here, I've seen the first generation ones and the second ones. The design of them is pretty eye-catching. It's very organic shapes. Has there been some type of generative design or something being used in CAD to come up with those shapes?
Yeah, absolutely. We use a topology optimization software to design these calipers. So you essentially take a space envelope, which is the wheel. You input some hard points that are fixed, such as the mounting points for the caliper, the pistons, etc. And then the software takes away material based on a weight target and a stiffness target. And so it takes away redundant material, leaves material that provides the strength for the product. And that's how you end up with these very organic, asymmetrical type of shapes.
Yeah, they're very eye-catching to say the least. Really cool looking parts and very light looking too. In terms of the those two generations, there seems to be a pretty clear difference between them, with the next generation not having the quickly changeable from the rear brake pads. Mm-hmm. What's the reasoning for that?
Well, the quick change pads were very important in endurance racing for a long time, but we've got to the point now where pad technologies come along where the pads will last longer, so fewer pad changes are required. But also in the very long races where you do change pads, a lot of times it's easier just to change the whole corner. So the teams will take the whole caliper off and put a new one on, so you have a fresh caliper with new pads, quick disconnects on the brake lines. So there's no need to have any kind of quick change on the pad itself.
Right, and I guess that also is adding to the stiffness of the caliper.
Exactly, yeah.
So that stiffness, you hear that a lot with brake calipers. Is that something that is kind of reserved for the higher ends of motorsport with professional drivers and extreme conditions, or is that something that's still important at an OEM or street car level? Is that something a non-professional driver could even feel?
Yeah, absolutely. Caliper stiffness is really important for any type of application. Even with our OE products, we have targets for caliper stiffness, because it not only gives you a good firm pedal feeling, but it reduces things like pad taper. What we're trying to do is make sure that all the effort that goes into the pedal is translated into clamping the disc and not effectively deflecting the caliper. So a stiffer caliper is going to give you a more efficient system. It's going to give you less pad taper, less issues with that kind of thing.
Yeah, right. On the topic of the pedal feel and the stiffness of it, we always see OEM cars with brake boosters, assisted power brakes, but it's very rare, especially at the higher ends of motorsport, that we see that in the race cars. What's the reasoning for this? Is there any reason for people to be, you know, as they're developing their performance car or it's getting to a racing application, to be changing to remove that power assist?
Well, race cars, you know, true race cars tend to be a lot lighter than the production car. So that's why you don't necessarily need a booster on a race car. If you're doing a lot of modifications to your car to go racing and taking weight out, then it would be worth going to a fully adjustable bounce bar type of setup to give you that ability to tune the brake system. But it has to be all sized correctly in order to work. Otherwise, you could find yourself with a system that won't stop the car.
Yeah, I guess tuning is everything with motorsport, for tracks, different conditions, different setups of the vehicle. So having that balance bar is definitely a tuning tool to be able to set that brake balance between the front and rear. Would you also be, you know, in terms of the pedal effort, that's one of the common things that people say, oh, when you're removing the booster, you're going to have a really heavy pedal feel. What needs to be considered there when you're moving to a non-powered system, keeping that pedal feel usable?
Mm. Well, the pedal effort will increase because, you know, that's what the booster's doing. But in selecting the right piston size in the master cylinder, you can affect what the pedal effort is. Typically, you'll be putting bigger brakes on, bigger discs, which increase the brake torque. And also, you know, racing pads have a higher friction coefficient, so you're getting some of that braking performance back. But with having the balance bar, like you say, you've got the adjustability front to rear, you can change master cylinder sizes, you've got a lot more options with that kind of system.
Yeah, cool, that makes a lot of sense. Just on the topic of stiffness, and I guess one of the key issues we hear with race cars is the brake knockback or kickback of the pads. Can you just explain briefly what causes that and what effect that has on the driver?
So knockback is when the rotor in the caliper is moving around and literally knocks the pistons back in the caliper. And what that does is it introduces extra piston travel, which to the driver means a lot more pedal travel. And this can be because things are flexing, there's deflection in the wheel bearing, or there's run out in the rotor, anything that could, you know, vibrate and knock the pads back, which in turn knocks the pistons back. Obviously, you want as stiff a system as possible to reduce that, but we also have a valve that we call an RRF valve, which is essentially an anti-knockback device that prevents those kind of knockback events. It reduces the amount of fluid that can go back into the master cylinder, keeps the pedal a lot more consistent without actually holding pressure in the caliper, because a residual pressure valve will actually, you know, keep pressure in the caliper and cause drag and generate heat and all those kind of problems.
Speed up wear and yeah, indeed. All that. I guess also with the knockback, that's pretty unconfidence inspiring at the end of a long straight at high speed for the driver.
Absolutely. I mean, a lot of drivers you'll see just giving the pedal a safety tap just to know it's there, and that's what that's about, is making sure you don't have the knockback. But it will destroy a driver's confidence if he doesn't know where his brake's actually going to start generating pressure.
Yeah, right. Okay, well, thank you for your time. And if anyone wanted to learn more about Alcon Brakes or have a look at the products, like, where's the best place to do that?
The best place is to visit our website, of course, alcon.co.uk, and you know, give us a call, send us an email.
Awesome. Thank you very much. Cheers.
Appreciate it.
If you like that video, make sure you give it a thumbs up. And if you're not already a subscriber, make sure you're subscribed. We release a new video every week. And if you like free stuff, we've got a great deal for you. Click the link in the description to claim your free spot to our next live lesson.